Now, I don't have any fond memories of variances when I did managerial accounting. And I think part of the reason why is there's so many terms that all sound very similar. In fact, what makes them, I think, so challenging on the exam is when out of the blue you get a question that says, well, what's the direct labor efficiency variance? And your brain starts thinking, which one's efficiency again? Is that with the quantity? And do I use the standard? And let's put that aside for the moment. What I want to do in this exercise is two things. One, give you a way to kind of logically organize these different variances so that it'll be a little easier for you to recall it. Make it less about strict memorization and more about, okay, this is what makes logical sense. And then we'll walk through in using that logic, here's the impact. Then you'll have the chance to practice it in the upcoming exercise. So first thing I want to do, we can break these off into pairs. When you boil it down, as we've seen in previous exercises, there's sales, direct materials, direct labor, fixed overhead, variable overhead. Those are the five variances we worry about here. Each pair has the same two ingredients. One is about dollars, and one is about units. Now, the terminology will change. If we're talking about direct materials, it makes sense that you talk about, well, how much did it cost to buy them, and how many did I use to make my whatever it is I'm making? When you think about direct labor, it makes sense to talk about it as a rate, right? We don't say what was the price of the person, we say what was their rate, what was their hourly wage. And it makes sense that we talk about efficiency, right? It's how many labor hours we used. It's still a usage of quantity, but we usually talk about, well, people are efficient or inefficient. Don't get so hung up on the terminology. As long as you go, which pair am I talking about? Am I talking about direct labor? Am I talking about direct materials? Then you know you're down to two. Then all you have to do, is it the dollar one or is it the quantity one? Then you've got it. And here's where you can apply just kind of a logical progression from that point. Here's what I mean. Let's just focus on direct materials for a moment. So one problem I could have with my direct materials is what I ended up paying was different than I expected, or I ended up using a different amount than I expected. Now, obviously, if I pay less, that's a good thing. If I use less, that's a good thing. On the contrary, if I pay more or use more, those are unfavorable. So favorability or unfavorability is really the easiest piece. It's saying, well, what would be good? Well, I think I'd like to pay less. I think I'd like to use less. Yes, and that's favorable. So the only question now is, if they actually had you calculate it, how do you do that? Well, when we're looking for the price variance, when we're looking for the dollar amount, that's always the part of the calculation that's a difference. Because you're wanting to understand, well, how different than what I expected was that thing? So if I'm looking for direct material price, I want to say, well, I expected this. Here's what I actually paid. What's that difference? Now, to understand the impact, I have to then multiply that times, well, for every item I bought, I'm incurring an extra X cents, or I was able to save X cents. I don't really care what quantity I thought I was going to purchase. That's not relevant. I want to know what I actually bought, and how much did I either overspend or underspend on each one. Now look at this one. This one is a quantity measure. Now the quantity is the difference. I expected to use this much. I actually used this much. And I'm going to multiply that times my standard price. Why not actual? Because then I'd be polluting, if you like, this quantity variance with a price. So I'm going to hold that as a standard. With each one now, I've completely isolated the price from the quantity. Put them together, I have my total variance for direct materials, because now I have separately assessed, here's what quantity did to me and here's what price did to me. Put them together, that's what happened to my direct materials in total. Let's apply the same logic to direct labor. Again, we've got a rate. Come on, rate. It just doesn't want to be circled. That's fine. We'll go over here. Just as above. If I'm looking for the rate, it's the difference in the rate that I'm concerned with times what I actually used. If it's an efficiency variance, then I'm interested in hours worked in actuality versus standard hours times the standard rate. Can you see that even though the terminology changed, it's a carbon copy, right? The quantity is what I actually use, or I should say for the rate variance, it's what did I actually use, what did I actually do, what did I actually use up in quantity, times the rate difference, and this one is, here's the rate I was expecting, here's the difference in the usage. It's just going to repeat itself. You can see that all the way down for variable overhead, rate, time. For fixed overhead, it's what I actually expected to spend versus What was my production expectation? Fixed overhead tends to be the one, kind of the oddest one, because you think, well, it's a fixed amount, right? Well, actually, it's not. In the sense that if I can produce more for the same fixed overhead, that's a good thing. If I can produce less with the same overhead, not so good. But then I can also end up spending more or less than I anticipated. So I still have a dollar's variance, and in a sense, I have a volume difference. It's just contrary. Normally, when I talk about using more, if I use more direct materials, that's bad. If I use more or get more out of my fixed overhead, that's why that one flips around, because it's actually a good thing to use more, but I'm not spending more to do it. The only other one that behaves like that, that's backwards, kind of makes sense. It's sales. That one, we want to go the other direction. We'd love for us to sell at a higher price than we thought. We'd love to be able to sell more than we anticipated. And that's why these are the only three on the list where more is better. For all the others, it's using less or spending less or both is better. So that hopefully gives you a good template to apply when you have to work on these problems on the exam.